Welcome to Access a Trader, the number one community for those who are committed to taking control of their trading in order to achieve success, profitability, and longevity. Thank you for joining us. Here's Dan Shapiro to help you find your edge, master your process, and own your future.
Hey guys, good morning everybody. Welcome to another adventure and episode of the AccessTheTrader.com weekend update show. Hope everybody is having a marvelous, blessed weekend, and hopefully you guys are enjoying yourself, getting some rest, because again, this market is really, really interesting. I think that's the best way to talk about it. Again, guys, you can go on, and I say this, you know, really frequently, you can go on 30,000 financial sites and, you know, they'll tell you the same thing. They'll tell you about the Saudi attacks, the drones, the Fed, and all that good stuff. Again, that's all great. Okay, that's all great. You can go on as CNBC and find that out. We are speaking and we're talking to the trader. Okay, it doesn't make a difference if the indexes go up 5%, down 1%, or anything in between. It's our job to talk about from the focal point of what every trader goes through, and from the novice trader who's first opening up their first brokerage account to the person who's been trading 15, 20, 25 years, and all everybody in between. And when you look at this week, first of all, really good macro action. Again, if you look at the macro point of view, and again, I always look at the macro point of view first. And again, we've been talking about this now for several weeks, how as long as the Qs are above this channel here, you have to give the bulls the benefit of the doubt every single time. As you can see, just with your eyes, every single time they backtest, whether the headlines is the Fed or the Saudi attacks, or whatever the case may be, every single time it goes back into, or tries to go back into the range, they bounce it up. You can see it here off the 50, off the here at the 20, off the 20 as well. So you really, really have to love the macro view of what is happening on the bullish side. But I tell you, okay, and this is where the market has completely changed in the last, especially like 10, 15 years, where it did my first 5 years. There are some ridiculously, and I mean ridiculously, I emphasize that with the word ridiculous 10 times. There is some ridiculous, aggressive measured potential on the downside. And when you look at the stocks, when they lose their ranges and there's a catalyst, whether it's a downgrade, whether it's Fed, you know, whether it's the FDA earnings, whatever the case may be, a lot of these names that have been big high flyers, ridiculously measured names that ran over shorts earlier part of the year, have been completely taken to the woodshed. And you can go through a whole laundry list of names that just gotten destroyed, like Shop and Roku, obviously. And this, you know, we'll talk about this all individually, and Netflix as well. And the most important part, and this is kind of where we've been talking about this now for a number of years. Again, the scoreboard means nothing. Up and down the indexes mean absolutely nothing. It means it's all about individual setups. And you know, the luxury 10, 12, 15 years ago that we had, well, if you miss a trade, there'll be another six others, doesn't work that way. It's all about, you know, waiting for that sweet underhand lob, softball to kind of try to drive it out of the park. And the dynamics of trading have really, really changed. Like, I don't sit there anymore anticipating six, seven trades a day. I try to bang out 2 to 4 really good measured potentials. At least they're setting up for the week. Again, cash flow in between them, 50 cents, $1.50 here. But when they really expand their channels, we'll talk about this in a second, when they really expand their channels and technicals get confirmed, not only on the 60-minute channel that I know a lot of you guys use, but when they mostly and most important confirm on the daily channels, it becomes an incredibly aggressive event. And you saw that, especially you saw that on Friday. I mean, Thursday going into Friday, but especially you saw that into Friday with Netflix, with Roku, and there's a couple of names that are setting up for next week. And I use this analogy all the time. For any of you guys who have been with me in the live webinar, you know, we've been doing this now for about 9.5 years. Okay, and I know some of you guys have been with me from day one. And if you ever watched any of the workshops, I use the word the Barry Sanders effect, and I use that terminology. And basically, since it's NFL Sunday, obviously it's a very, very important analogy. You know, Barry Sanders, again, for all you guys who've never watched football, which is a sin by itself, is arguably one of the best running backs, one of the most elusive, creative running backs. And he played on a very, very bad team. And on that bad team was a horrendous offensive line. And other teams used to stack the box, like really, really stack the box, 8-9-man fronts against Barry Sanders to stop him. And a lot of times he would run, you'd look at his stats and in the first half, he would have 9 carries for 23 yards, which basically meant every single time he got the ball, he would get hit right away and the play would be over. And then you look at the end of the game, okay, and you look at his stat sheet and it has 14 rushes for 123 yards and a touchdown, which basically means, and you can kind of use the analogy going into stocks, every stock trades. Guys, remember that. There's 25, 30,000 stocks between the NASDAQ, the OTC, the New York Stock Exchange, the Amex, anything in between. There's 25, 30,000 vehicles out there that you can trade. Okay, so every single stock moves, okay, but not every single stock is tradable. And the problem with that is when you're a new trader and you're looking at stocks to buy or stocks to short or anything in between, you're looking at a candle that is in the middle of momentum. Because again, the majority of new traders, what do? They look at the new high list, look at the new low list, and they're trying to formulate an opinion and try to formulate a battle plan within that stock that already has probably made at least 90% of its average true range. And again, if that's your thing, that's your thing. That's great. I personally can't, I can't wire myself. I never was able to wire myself outside of the internet craze that I can buy a stock up 60% of the day and think I'm going to make money. Or even the worst part of it is on the front side, shorting a stock up 60% part of the day and expect to make money on day one. So a lot of traders get, they really fall in love with the momentum and kind of take technicals and put it to the backside. And how does this affect, like the Barry Sanders effect is, you are buying or shorting stock with the average true potential has already been made. So the market, right? The market gods, the active market participants, they're stacking the box against you. Okay. You're constantly have buyers that are chasing or shorts that are entering with very unattractive levels, and they don't even know it because, again, they don't really embrace technical analysis. They're more believing and engulfing in the story or the lack of the story, and they keep on getting stuffed over and over. And you can go back into that whole 1 minute candle, 5 minute candle, 15 minute candle view because you're constantly getting more active market participants within each candle that are forming and are stacking the box against you. And the problem is when you are trading these 99% of these stacked boxes, you keep on churning your account. So that's why I see a lot of new traders talking about they traded 8-9 stocks of the day, and then they're talking about they made or lost $67. That doesn't even make sense to me, okay? That doesn't even make sense. You can't put on a trade and at the end of the day have 9 stocks to trade and you made $60. Made or lost $60. That's not trading. That is, you are Barry Sanders and you're running into the line every single time. When Barry Sanders finally broke one, okay, he went for 60, 70 yards, and that's when technical analysis opens up the floodgates. So when you look at, for example, a measured potential move on a Netflix, a Roku, an Amazon, or a Tesla, the biggest moves, they don't come when there's a $1.50 range going from supply to supply or demand to demand. They're coming when technicals on the daily gets confirmed, the 60-minute channel is clean, the 5-minute channel makes sure there's nothing interrupted entering on the 60-minute channel, and then like Moses, he parts the Red Seas and these things really, really go. Obviously, a catalyst makes sense. You want a catalyst, you want the wind at your back, but you are looking for that one hole, right? One hole that takes your day from 9 carries to 23 yards to 10 carries to 156 yards and a touchdown. And that's the name of the game. And I've been saying this to new traders all the time, especially you guys who are trading options. And I think a lot of you guys finally really saw the light this week, okay? You don't need to trade. I'm an equity guy, okay? I would say the webinar right now is split probably 60-40 equity to options, okay, option players. And the one common denominator is when you're an equity guy, okay, and you could buy the equity on Tesla and get that cash flow trade, 75 cents, $1, $1.50, that's great. If you're an options trader, right? If you're an options trader and that channel is small, right? 50 to, okay, the stock can stall out. I could still make some money in the trade. You are fighting time, okay? You're fighting time. And every single time the stock can't bust out of that channel, there's a very, very good chance you're probably going to lose money on that option, okay? You're probably, because again, you're fighting time. And the more the stock keeps on getting rejected off those 8-9 man fronts like Barry Sanders does, you're going to lose money or have a lot of really break-even trades. But when the floodgates open, like we just talked about, and that stock confirms, like really, really confirms, it becomes magic. It really becomes magic. And that's when you can really take advantage. And that's why I keep on telling the newer option traders, the newer, you know, especially when you have smaller accounts. Again, you don't need to trade every day. Okay. You don't need to trade every single day. You don't need to, you know, trade those Netflix trades that, you know, it maybe goes up, you know, 75 cents, a dollar just to take some quick cash flow. You don't need to trade, you know, that 40 cent move on Facebook. Just wait. Technicals will confirm whether they confirm today, tomorrow, they will confirm. And when they do, that's when your Barry Sanders effect really comes into play. And when you look at Friday's day, okay, well, you know, pretty much all of the week, but when you look at Friday's day, you can really see what measured potential looks like. And for example, so Friday, Thursday, we had a, you know, really nice trade on Netflix, right? That 290 area. That 290 area we talked about, you know, it came in, you know, $4 or $5. That was great. But I kept on talking about 282 is a big number. Okay. 282 is a big number. This is where they can't stock the box anymore. Okay. They just can't do it because again, that hole is starting to open up. And when you get that hole starting to open up, that is your chance as a professional trader. And again, professional trader doesn't mean 20 years. Professional trader is any person, you could be trading for 3 days. Any person who's putting their hard-earned money, okay, your money is just as good as mine. Your money is just as good as anybody else. And don't think for a second just because you're trading for 3 days, your money means less to you than it does to us. I mean, it's complete false. But when the gap starts opening up, that is your time. And you know, here's a perfect example. 282 is next measured potential. I mean, once that breaks and once that hole opens up, Barry Sanders will take it to the house, and you can see why 282 opened up the floodgates, right, guys? Everybody see this? So 282 area here, 282 area. And again, measured potential, we talked about roughly the 269 area. That's your measured potential. And once it broke and Barry got that hole, it was gone, right? It was absolutely gone. And my stock actually went down all the way down to the 266 level. But I mean, just an absolutely huge move. And again, we're not highlighting Netflix, okay? We're not talking about Netflix. And again, guys, congratulations to everybody who got Netflix. That was great. I mean, that was absolutely great. We're not talking about Netflix. We're talking about the ability to wait till the floodgates open up and Moses parts the Red Sea. That's all we're talking about here, guys. And when you're a new trader, it's so important that you wait for these trades, because if you don't, okay, if you don't, you will be churning yourself over and over again. You'll get frustrated. You're going to burn a lot of mental, you know, a lot of mental equity. And again, you might get your money back, but it's very, very tough to get your mental equity back. And it took me years and years and years. I'm talking about years. It took me literally, I would say it probably took me 10 to 12 years to really emotionally detach from everything. And again, for all you guys see me in the live webinar, I'm very, very calm. Even when I have a day that I can't get going and I lose some money, I'm very, very calm because again, it's the cost of doing business. So when the stock goes in our favor, I'm going to be equally as calm because again, we expect that measured potential to play out. Again, does it do it all the time? Of course not, right? There's always curveballs. There's always areas in the market that just do not make sense. And we say this all the time, charts don't lie, but sometimes they don't tell you the truth either, or at least right away. So there's a lot of curveballs and makes trading super damn hard and it makes it super frustrating at times. But again, you have to trust the process. You have to trust technical analysis, and you have to trust the ability when a stock trades and finally that hole opens up that Barry Sanders is going to take it to the house. So really, really great job there. And again, if you look at Friday's measured potential, some really good stuff, guys. And it really does show how good the market overall is right now. Again, especially after Labor Day, that we saw really great liquidity come back as all the players are back from vacations, the Hamptons, this, that, and the other thing. So we're getting great liquidity. The spreads are tighter and the plays are very, very vicious once they start stretching out and getting some legs. So if you look at the macro view, right, the macro view cues are very, very healthy despite rotation in shops and Rokus and Netflix and all that good stuff. But when you look at all the other, all the other names, right? You look at the banks and you say, wow, man, look at the nice move that Bank of America has made. I mean, look at the nice move that Citibank has made. Look at the retailers, right? They talk about the retailers, recession and this, that, the other thing. Until recently, look how great these moves are. So the market itself has been very, very healthy. And as I'm looking right now, I'm actually seeing some pretty good setups to the downside. And the retail is not my thing, but for all you guys at home, you might want to start looking at the retail just by some areas of interest on the charts here. But again, we have a very, very healthy market right now. Again, I think the bulls are winning. I think the bears are winning. And the traders that have the best process or a process that can take advantage of the uneducated trader will always win, again, in a long-term period of time because they're practicing patience. They are waiting for the line to get thin and they're ready to bust through it into the goal line. So Friday session, very good. I had one losing day this week. I had a day I couldn't make money. What day was that? I think that was on Wednesday. I just couldn't get anything going. I had a couple of trades. I took a couple of bounce plays. One I made money, one I lost money. I just really couldn't get anything going. There's certain days that my way of trading, because again, I don't need contraction. The last thing I want to see is Amazon trading a $3 candle. Last thing I want to see is Netflix trading the 50 cent range. Like those days, they just become impossible because again, there's no room, right? There's absolutely no room for measured potential. So I always say, again, why play the 2-7 offsuit if you can wait for the premium hand? And once the premium hand came Thursday and spilling over into Friday, it became really, really good. So if you look at Friday's session, very aggressive, right? I think that's the best way of saying it. And again, first thing that we talked about, congrats to all the shorts who came into Netflix. Again, we started shorting in the 290 area. Now, any build under 282, and again, this whole streaming war is in full, everybody's in streaming now. You got Amazon, you got Apple, you got Netflix, you got Roku, you got Hulu, you got freaking, my mother-in-law, I think, is starting a streaming service. Don't go with hers. Bad news. But everybody's getting into the streaming business. You know, you have NBC Universal, you have Comcast giving it away and all that stuff. And this is affecting the early players, right? This is really affecting the early players. And it's really presenting a catalyst and always the next shoe to fall in the Netflix, in the Rokus. Look, Apple and Amazon will be okay. Streaming can go away. I mean, like Apple right now introduced the video game streaming, I think it was like $5 a month, which is genius, absolute genius. And they're not reinventing the wheel. Right? They're just taking what's out there and they're going to monetize the shit out of it. So it's very, very important that sometimes you might not have creativity anymore in your products. So again, everybody loves Apple products. You're talking about the iPads, the iPods, the iToilets, and everything in between. But again, $4.99, anybody can afford $5, and you're getting that demographic between the ages of like 12 to 30 that, $5 a month, what's the big deal? And they're going to get killed. So streaming could, they don't care about streaming. That goes away, they'll be fine. They have $250 billion in the bank, for God's sake. But a lot of these companies, like a Roku, like a Netflix, they're starting to get the squeeze. You know, Disney's coming in, NBC, all this stuff. They're getting their own channels, their own streaming services. And again, it's going to be a crunch. So every headline you're seeing are really punishing these stocks. So if you look at the measured potential of some of these moves, really, really big moves here. Netflix, we talked about a really good move here. Tesla never got up there, right? Tesla never got up to that 248.75, 249 level. We'll talk about Tesla in the live webinar tomorrow at Morning Strategy. There's a sneaky area to the downside, right? There's a sneaky area to the downside that if it cracks, could be really, really good. So anyway, monster move on Netflix. Here's a trade that I did. And for all you guys who took this pivot, it was kind of the gift and the curse, okay? If you guys took this pivot, exactly. Like, in a million years, I didn't think Roku was going to do what it did, okay? And I'm telling you this right now. I thought what was going to happen was, because of the previous aggressive move, what I thought was going to happen was Roku was going to take out the pre-market low of 125.50, right? And I thought there was a potential within the half hour, an hour or so, as the stock kept on moving down, I thought it had the potential to get to 123.70s. So I put on, and again, as you can see here what I said, I go, if it builds below, it can see 123.70s, that's the rising Bollinger Band. So what happened next was kind of like the gift and the curse. So I shorted Roku, and I know a lot of you guys shorted as well. It sat there for about 5 seconds, right? It took out the pre-market low. And if you look what happened, okay, and if you look what happened, and a lot of people, again, always complain about algorithms and, oh my God, they're so bad. Not if you're trading on the right side of the pivot, right? Not if you're trading the right side of the pivot. And here is the, you know, so here was the pivot right here. Forget about all this, okay? Forget about all this. This was the pivot right here. It was 125.50. It was the pre-market low. And here was the Bollinger Band right here, 123.70s. Okay, so that was my, that was all I wanted. I wanted 123.70. You give me a trade from one, you know, 125.50s on the equity side to 123.70s. I'm a pig in, you know, I'm a pig in crap. Okay, and if you look what happened, right? And if you look what happened, I'm gonna show you the 5-minute chart. There was a flash crash. Okay, there was an absolute flash crash. Literally, there was an absolute flash crash from 125 to like 123, I would say in about 5 seconds, okay? There was an absolute flash crash in the stock. So naturally, and you guys, again, you guys know, there's no emotion for me. I literally squealed like a pig. I go, oh my God, right? It's like somebody was grabbing my ass. I literally squealed like a pig because the candle went down so fast. So obviously, I was we were all out, right? I think at least all of us on the equity side, we were all out. I mean, how do you not take that move? Like, how do you not take $1.50, $2 in a matter of seconds, okay? And then literally 15 seconds later, which 99% of the time will never happen, 15 seconds later, it gets through the Bollinger Band on one candle and has one of the massive, massive unwinds that I could, like literally seeing. So again, it was kind of the gift and the curse, but man, oh man, if you caught that move, and I know a lot of you guys who are trading to the option side, I know a lot of you guys did really, really well, but who the hell can predict a 12-run home run, especially technically, that we know, right? That we absolutely know 9 out of 10 times is going to stop at the Bollinger Band. But again, it's the wonders of trading. It's the greatest reality show that's not on television. So Roku is... crazy. CGC, we talked about again, with all the, you know, with all the distilleries and all that stuff that's being opened up all around the country, these pot stocks just get no love, man. They really don't. I think they missed their window. You know, the whole pot revolution lasts like 15 minutes. There's just no momentum in these things. They just can't get off the ground. And CGC, we talked about it. 26 is daily support. If it builds below, it can flush. So here was CGC, right? Here was CGC. Took out the 26, went down to, I thought it went down more. Again, as you know, I wasn't trading CGC. Actually went down to 25, but again, looks like a dollar on a $26 stock. Xilinx, I wasn't really watching Xilinx. Xilinx, 99.50 held 2 times pre-market. If it builds below, it could attract more selling. Let me just see Xilinx. What do we say? 99.5. Yeah, it looks like it went down to 95. Any of you guys trade? I didn't trade this thing. It looks like it went down another 3. Again, it basically my point of all these things, you don't need anybody to hold your hand. Okay. If I'm trading Tesla, Netflix, and Roku, I'm trading Tesla, Netflix, and Roku. It doesn't make a difference. The market gods don't care if I'm trading CGC and XLNX. They're either gonna work or they're not. So I always tell everybody, trade the stocks that you feel very, very comfortable. You have Wayfair started a sell, 125 strong daily support. If it builds below, it has measured potential of 121. If you look at Wayfair, you know, did traded exactly what we thought. Here's the 125 pre-market, right? Here's the 125 pre-market, and went all the way down to 121.60. NVIDIA again, NVIDIA is one that is very, very close to cracking. I mean, very, very close on the daily chart. We'll talk about that in a few minutes. But NVIDIA, you know, 176 held twice. If it builds below, it can flush. And again, here's NVIDIA, right? Here's NVIDIA itself, right? Here's the 176.50, right? This whole channel here, 176.50, 176.52. And once it cracked 176.50, went all the way down to the 72 area. Again, the daily chart on NVIDIA does not look good, guys. Not look good. One more confirmation. It could get there. Apple, 222 bill to the upside. I didn't think that was a big one. I think Apple only went up like 20 cents or so. I don't think that one worked. 22 actually went up to 23.76. Yeah, just again, some ridiculous moves. And here's, now check this out. Here is where my second vagina saved me. Okay. Here's where my second vagina saved me. So I missed, obviously, the bulk of the move. Believe me, if you told me I was going to be in a short flash crash, I had signed up any single day. So don't, let's take that out of the equation. So if you would have told me, right, if you would have told me what would have went down to 110, I wouldn't believe it because, again, you can't, there's nothing you can do to prepare yourself for a 12-run home run. It's just impossible. So somebody asked me, well, what do you think if it builds 118? I was looking at 118. I go, wow, this thing is getting killed there. I go, look, the measured potential, and this gentleman, and great job by Goku Trades on the private feed, he said, well, look, isn't there a measured potential of 110? And the reason why he said 110, if you look at 110 on Roku, this was the weekly chart, right? This is the weekly support right here, this rising weekly support at 109.72, this 110 area. And I said, look, it's a gun to my head, right? I do think it gets there, right? I do think it gets there, but there's no edge. There's no edge anymore in this momentum. It's just aggressive momentum. So ironically, it got down to the 110 level. And I know a lot of us in the live webinar, we took that 110 bounce. And I bought it at 110. And I'm talking, I went to like 109.60 in about a second, or it went down and then it reclaimed 110 right away. And it started ripping up, right? It started ripping up to like the 111 area. And I said in the room, we joked around, I go, I'm going to keep this thing for a longer term move. Right? I'm going to keep this thing for a longer term move. We all started laughing because, look, we all know, we all know, man. Once things get hairy and there's any type of sign of something that's about to go wrong, I'm out of this trade, right? So it was bouncing 110, 111. They just couldn't reclaim that 5-minute supply at 111. And then it went down to 109.50 and then it reclaimed 110 and it went back to 107.75. And I was like, I'm out of this thing. So I wound up playing the bounce. And I know a lot of you guys took the trade. Phil flipped it. I know Sam flipped it as well. I wound up flipping it, and I feel like such a sucker doing it. I flipped it for literally like 52, 53 cents, but whatever, man. I just wasn't feeling comfortable. It couldn't reclaim that 111, and the stock actually went down to like, where the hell did it go down to? I think it went down to like 103. So, yeah, my second vagina definitely saved me for the day. And again, I always say, guys, safe than sorry. That's the name of the game, safe than sorry. It doesn't make a difference how your money got there or how you save your money. The point is it's there. Okay. It's there. And again, it's not about ego. It's not about being right. It's about being an adult and trying to trade measured potential. That's the name of the game. Some trades are going to be big and some trades are just going to be cash flow, but the name of the game is stay solvent. As you can see here, again, 269, it's coming, new lows in the video. So very, 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 very strong session. And this was the last, pivot. This is the last pivot I put. Amazon. I'm not an Amazon, but I will be watching it for sure on Monday. We talked about this. Any close under 1795 can see 1745. And again, if you look at Amazon, again, this is basic technical analysis, guys. Here's all the channels that it confirmed, and it went as low as to 1780. I think if Amazon starts confirming, there's a shot. And the reason why I say 1745. There's a shot that if it starts confirming, goes all the way down to the 1747 Bollinger, which, by the way, will come even more down on Monday and Tuesday. So very, very strong session, really, really strong session. I think, again, the light bulb really went on for a lot of you guys. Okay, it's so important, guys. Again, if you're trading equity, you have a good size account. Look, you have the luxury to take the 50 cent trade, the 30 cent trade, the 80 cent trade. If you're trading on the option side, especially if you're a newer trader, you can't afford to put on 6 option trades with a maximum potential of a 75. So you're not going to get anywhere. You're really not going to get anywhere. This week I will be concentrating on new potential channels. Again, like I said before, guys, watch some of these retail names, even though they're not officially on our watch list. Start watching them. I mean, I just looked at the charts a couple minutes ago. Home Depot's starting to crack. Costco is starting to crack. But again, I'm starting to look at a lot of names like NVIDIA, first close below support. I'm looking at Amazon, right? I'm looking at Amazon. BYND, don't think we forgot about you. The stock has stopped going up on these random PRs. It didn't go up with this last upgrade from Barclays. And again, as the old saying goes, whatever doesn't go up must go. Anyway, guys, have an awesome, awesome Sunday. For all you guys who are joining us in a live webinar tomorrow, please get there around 9:05. For all you guys who are joining us tomorrow via the Twitter feed, again, I know a lot of you guys have jobs and all that stuff. The pivots will start going in roughly around 9 a.m. God bless everybody. Love somebody. Learn to smile. Life is not that serious. And with God's help, I'll see you all in the field tomorrow. Have a blessed day, guys. See you tomorrow.
Congratulations for putting in the time to take control of your trading. You're one step closer to owning your future and achieving the success you desire. Want daily trade ideas directly from Dan, straight off his personal watch list? Unlock our free PS60 Vault, where you'll get nightly updates on pivot opportunities we're watching for the next day's session. Click the link in the description to get started today.